There is a two version, Python 2.7 and Python 3. In Python 3 and 2.7, problem with division operation is there. Executing Python 3 point code in Python 2.8 can be dangerous. Result will be different. Similarly, for problem with printing operation, there is a printing method. If I show you, if I write print, hello world. So it is displaying. The same thing will not be possible to run. Like, for example, if you write print, hello world, it will still run without this first bracket. But in case of Python 3, it is not possible to run. If I exit from this and if I run Python 3 and if I write print, an error has given. For the same thing, it is executing at 2.7, but at 3.9, it is not running. It is giving error. Also, there is a problem with the character representation. In Python 2, character type will be the ASCII character. And Python 3.x will use Unicode. Unicode is another way to represent the character, but it is the most recent one and updated one. What are the differences? In ASCII, you have 128 characters. But in case of Unicode, you have many characters, more than that, because in case of ASCII, 7-bit is used to represent a particular character. But in case of Unicode, it uses 8-bit, 16-bit, 32-bit. So depending on the type of encoding, it uses character. And because it is 7-bit, means it requires less space in memory, but Unicode requires more space in memory. This is the ASCII table, where each of the number in decimal, like 1, 2, 3, 4, or the character like null, start of heading, all these things, how you it is written in this decimal form and hexadecimal form. Next is X range. There is a function called X range. If you use X range in one version, that will give you one way of representation. If you use another version in Python 3.x, it will not run. Check it which version you are using, and then write the program correspondingly, that whether there is a mismatch with the version or not, and then the correct those functions or those particular component, and then the program will run. Next thing is Python packages. The Python installation does not come pre-installed with all the fancy features. So at the beginning, when you will install your Python software, it will not consist of all the packages, like for different data analysis, different small program, different image analysis, more complex problem. All the packages are not installed. You have to install those packages whenever you need those packages. So that package actually a form of module. It is called Python packages are like collection of modules, package structures, Python module. Python modules have pre-written code that other developers have created. So there are some developers who create some code on behalf of you, and you can use those code on your program. So that will be more helpful for you. So modules are handy when you are looking for a specific functionality. For example, there are different modules that are available. You want to work with image, then you need to install the packages available for image. You want to create graph, so that you have to install packages for graph, Python package index. PY stands for PI and PI stands for package index. If you go to this site, then you will find this one, where you can see lot of Python projects. Python different versions are available, and for different version, different packages are available. So if you click it, so for Python 3.9, what are the packages are available? It is given here. So you can find, say, like 10,000 plus projects with selected classifier is available in this case. When you will learn more about all these things, you need to look at these components. But for your basic programming, to understand different programming concept, you really don't need all those packages. To handle these packages, you need to install Python package manager. And in your system, you can install different Python package managers. There are like PIP, virtualenv, anaconda, miniconda, pyenv, ipython, Jupyter, Google Colab, these all these like package managers are available by which you can manage your different packages needed for different application or solving different problem. So what is this IPython? What is the meaning of this IPython? IPython stands for interactive Python. So Python interpreter starts by using Python command by terminal. So like for example, in this case, so this is the terminal. And now at the beginning, if you want to go into the Python environment and the Python interpreter, that means where you can run your Python code, the object who is responsible for converting your Python code into machine understandable format. To launch this one, you need to run Python. So by default, if you type Python, then it will go for Python 2.7 or Python 2.x. But if you want to use Python version 3, then you have to use Python 3. Okay, and then it will use, see, at the beginning when I have used Python, it is using Python 2.7. But if I use Python 3 as a command, then it is using Python 3.9.2. So Python code run using Python interpreter, and the limitation is you have to write everything in this black window. It will not give you any hints. For example, if you write P, then what are the functions available with P, that will not give you as a hint. If you just started in this programming, you have to remember the function name and the packages available. You have to remember all those things. Does not provide proper indentation. Like for example, so if I write something like this and give print X, it will still give some error. See, the error is indentation error. So that means it is automatically not giving indentation, which is a very essential thing to write Python code. Indentation means the block. In case of module, you have to create a block, and that block will be identified by the indentation. If I write the same sentence here, then I have to give a tab, and then I have to write print and then X, and then if I enter, then it will give you the execute the code. So since I'm using Python 3.9, this X range is not available here. You have to use range, print X, range 1 to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the very values of in this range will be printed. But if you miss this space, this is called missing indentation. If you miss this one, then it is called missing indentation. And in this case, the program will not run. And you have to give this indentation by your hand. But there are possible options are available where you don't have to write this by hand. Whenever you press enter, it will give you indentation automatically. So that's why there is a solution for this, and that is called IPython, an alternative Python interpreter like this. Okay, like the command-based interpreter. IPython is another interactive interpreter. It uses an interactive shell used for computing in Python. So two way to install this IPython, we have to use pip install IPython. Like for example, if I use here, first exit and then write pip. Let's see if it will install fine, else we'll show you in the next class. IPython. So pip command is not found. So that means you have to install pip. That means the package manager that is not installed here, who will help you to install this IPython. So you have to install pip first, and then you can install IPython next. Okay. So these things will be like, for example, to install pip, to manually install pip, securely download get pip py by following this link. So you have a link here. If you go to this link, okay, it will download this page. Okay, you have to download this page, and then you have to execute this. So for Mac or Windows, you download it and run the Python get pip.py. Okay, once the run the following command in the folder where you have downloaded. So first you have to download this file, and then you have to run it by using Python command. So like for example, if I download this one, Okay. It is downloaded in the download box. Now, so I have to go to the downloads, CD, DOW and downloads, and then LS. Okay. So you have this one. See, this file is here, getpip.py. So now you have to use this Python command. So Python 3, maybe Python, okay, Python get pip.py. Okay. And it says the script does not work on Python 2.7. The minimum support version is 3.6. So since I have used Python, it automatically detects Python 2.7. Okay, but the version I have downloaded is the latest version, and I have installed the latest version software in different place, and that will use Python 3. So you have to use Python P and then click enter. So now it is installing, downloading, and then installing. If you are using Python 3, in that case, you have to use this one on Python 3. If in your system Python 2 is not installed, remember, if in your system Python 2 is not installed, then Python, only Python means Python 3. Okay. But if in your system Python 3 and Python 2 both are installed, and the default version is the Python 2, whichever is installed earlier. If you are installing your Python software in your system first time, then you don't have to use this one. You can use this one only. And if you have any problem, then just type Python 3 getpip.py. So that is installed. Now I want to install the previous command. That is pip install IPython. See? Collecting IPython, downloading IPython, which is 784 KB. So it is installing IPython components. All the IPython components are installing. So all these packages, WC with P-type, PTY process, Parso, IPython, datelets, pigments, all these packages are collected and successfully installed. See, in the next line, it is successfully installed. So now you have IPython. We may need to use these softwares for writing Python code. And that's all for today. And hope it is not late for you. Since I have started late, it is, I ended little late. So if you have any query, you can ask. Else, we will stop. Hello?
I think no, sir. Everything is clear.
Okay. So shall I end the session?